Assalamu alaikum, sisters, and welcome back to my page. My name is Claudia Nour. I am the creator of Claudia Nour Cosmetics, which is a line of makeup and skincare that is made with all natural, halal, and voodoo friendly ingredients. And in today's video, I want to speak with you a little bit about what is halal makeup. Now, halal makeup usually gets defined as makeup that is free of alcohol, pork, or carmine. But is that really all that halal makeup is? And let's get one thing clear. Makeup that is free of these ingredients is indeed halal makeup. Because the word halal, what it actually means is just something that is permissible. And for us as Muslims, there are a lot of things that are permissible, and then there are a few of them that are not, like alcohol and pork, insects, the blood of animals, animals that have been used for worshipping or for idolatry, animals that were sick, animals that are contaminated with impure substances like blood and urine and feces and bacteria. So these are things that we are not allowed to consume. So now you might be wondering, but we are talking about makeup and you are talking about food. And you are right, but these two are very closely related because a lot of the ingredients in the cosmetics industry are actually byproducts of the food industry. So that's why it is very important for us to know what is in our products, because why would we take a substance that is impermissible for us to consume and apply it in our skin? That would mean that when we are praying, we're not really in a state of purity. We have things on us that shouldn't be there, that are considered impermissible. And that's why the food that we eat is very closely related with what products we are applying on our skin. And the other reason is that if you think about our skin, which is the largest organ in our bodies, it is porous, and there have been studies that have shown that what we apply on our skin can end up in our bloodstream, meaning that our skin is absorbing the things that are applied onto it. And even if you think about something like lipstick, which is in direct contact with our lips, and also, studies have shown that we are actually eating the lipsticks that we apply, like little by little throughout our days, even when we eat or when it gets smeared, or just like when we talk and when we go on about our days, we are eating little by little. Our lipstick can get into our system. So for these reasons, we want to be really aware of what we are choosing and the things that are going on in our bodies. So now that you have a better idea about what the term halal means, I would like to take it a step further, because is halal really only about these ingredients? And this is something that I researched a lot when I first started creating my own line of halal makeup and skincare, is that there are other factors that we as Muslims have to take into consideration when we are purchasing a product. Like, let's take for example, if a brand is not eco-friendly, if it's not aware of the impact that they have on the environment, and with the emphasis that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with the emphasis that he put into us as Muslims taking care of the earth and taking care of this trust that Allah has put on us, shouldn't we as consumers, because we are supporting these brands with our money and our purchases, shouldn't we take into consideration that if a brand is not really eco-friendly, that maybe it shouldn't be considered by us as halal? Another example is, if a brand is known for testing on animals, animal cruelty, I don't think that brand should be considered halal by us as Muslims consumers. Another, if there is a brand that is sponsoring oppression against our Muslim brothers and sisters throughout the world, we shouldn't really be supporting them with our purchases. This is a responsibility that really falls on our shoulders as Muslim consumers, because the word halal usually just means that it doesn't have these ingredients that are considered impermissible. But we have to have a bigger viewpoint on what this term actually means. If you want to learn a little more about halal makeup and go into details about what substances can be halal and which ones can be derived from products that are not halal, you can go to claudianour.com/halal makeup and you can see a full list of ingredients that could possibly be haram and could possibly be halal depending on the source, and a lot of other things that you as a consumer should be aware of, because it's just knowledge that is going to benefit you, inshallah. I hope that you guys like this video, and I will see you on the next one. Assalamu alaikum.